everyone, welcome to examination. So today's topic is about the health, which is part 2 section. I have already mentioned that I have divided this topic into 6 sections. So let's not waste any time, let's get started with the first topic, which is that of the content section, where we get to see Zearalenone in cereals. Second one is that of the World Malaria report of 2018, non-communicable diseases. Fourth one is that of the trans fats, while the fixed fifth one is that of the fixed dose combination. So first is that of the Zearalenone in cereals. So Zearalenone is basically a fungal toxin which is found in cereals such as that of wheat, maize and barley, which are basically the cereals get made, and this attacks the crops when they are growing, when they are in their growing stage, and it also develops when the cereals are not kept in stored without being fully dried. Now this has been recently found out by the Journal of Food Science, which have detected Zearalenone in wheat, rice, corn, oats in Uttar Pradesh. So let's move forward to the next slide, where we get to see that the study by researchers from the Lucknow Indian Institute of Toxicology Research found out that the substance in 70 of 117 samples, and the food safety standards do not impose any maximum limit, while the European Union does. Aflatoxin, deoxynivalenol, ergot, just have been found in the fungal toxins which have been found in cereals, while this is found in the apples. In case aflatoxin is basically a group 1 carcinogen, which is a cancer causing agent, aflatoxin is basically one in the group 1 section, while that of the Zearalenone is classified as the group 3 section, the group 3 section of the carcinology. It basically behaves as the oestrogen, which is found in the female hormones, which causes disturbance in humans, and it gives a side effect in animals such as that of the pigs. That is why pigs develop inflated vaginas, infertility and other symptoms. That is why countries like Brazil need to regulate their Zearalenone levels in animal feed. So let's move forward to the next slide, where we get to see the World Malaria report. India is one of the countries where it saw substantial progress in it, 24% decrease in 2017 as compared to 2016, and the malaria the year's report shows after an period of success in the global malaria control, progress has been stalled. Data from 2015 to 2017 highlight that no significant process in reducing malaria cases was made in this period, while in the malaria report 2080 draws from that of 87 countries area with ongoing malaria transmission. This is basically at the East Asia Summit in 2015. India pledged to eliminate this disease by 2018. It has achieved it. The road plan also derives that 571 districts out of India's 676 districts to eradicate malaria from it. So let's move forward to the next slide, where we get to see the Durgami Anchala malaria Nikaran. So this is quite significant in Odisha state, and it has been jointly implemented by the Indian Council of Medical Research, National Institute of Malaria Research, National Vector Borne Disease Control Program, and Medicines for Malaria Venture. Let's move forward to the next slide, where we get to see the non-communicable diseases, which is also known as the chronic diseases. It has a name of chronic disease and tends to be of a longer duration infection, it is mainly of the cardiovascular diseases, respiratory diseases, etc. It is basically based on that. It is lead to it basically the WHO has listed this as the health goal of for this year. So related basically to air pollution and climate change and global warming, it has the NCDs has recently caused around 70% of the deaths, and the four major NCDs that of the tobacco use, unhealthy diet, insufficient physical activity, and harmful use of alcohol. So trans fats. Let's move forward to the trans fat, which is also known as unsaturated fatty acids or trans fatty acids, or it is a type of unsaturated fat that occurs in small amounts in nature but is widely produced in the industry from vegetable fat starting in 1950s. And for used in margarine, snack food, packaged food, etc. And frying foods also. It is to eradicate these trans fats and eliminate it by 2022. The Food Safety Standards Authority of India has launched this campaign. Now the Heart Attack Rewind, which is a 30-second public service announcement, which is broadcasted basically in 17 languages on 4 weeks on YouTube, all on all the social media platforms, and it has been also done in our hoardings in Delhi and also the capital. It has been a follow-up to the earlier campaign, which is Eat Right, and on which was launched on July 11, 2018, as a part of the campaign. It is to reduce the trans fat contents by 2% by 2022. Now, what is the definition of trans fats? It basically, the trans fats is that which I have already mentioned. It is a type of unsaturated fat that occurs in small amounts in nature but widely produced in the industrially from vegetable fat starting in 1990s. These fats has been largely produced artificially. It basically causes cardiovascular diseases and all. In our diet, the major source of the trans fats are partially hydrogenated vegetable oil, vanaswati, and all these stuffs. So the artificial are made up of when hydrogen is made to react with oil to produce fats, resembling ghee and egg. I have already mentioned that a lot of heart disease gets caused, total cholesterol levels also, good cholesterol level gets reduced, it develops heart diseases, obesity, fat, heart disease, metabolic syndrome, insulin, and all. Who recommends basically to limit this by 1% of the total and total elimination of the trans fats by 2023. So let's move forward to the initiative which is done by Kerala. Now Kerala is planning to launch and enforce dietary guidelines so as to reduce this trans fat system. This has been under the ministry. This has been under the technical support of the World Bank, WHO, Food Safety Standards, which launched trans fat as an unhealthy diet and pushing up the metabolic syndrome and premature deaths. Now the fixed dose combinations. The health minister prompted a list of banned combination medicines and added restrictions to the doses or the uses of 6 or more types of drugs, saying that their ingredients has no therapeutic value and their risk for combination. 110 anti-tuberculosis fixed dose were available in India. Only 32% of it has been approved by the Central Drug Standard Control Organization. And if this is a cocktail of the two or more drug, and under this drug cosmetics act CDSCO, the Central Standard Control Organization is approval for the new drugs of the trend, and this Central Drug Standard under the General Service Ministry of Health and Welfare, Government of India, and the regulatory national authority of India. The ban on 328 such drugs compared to with that of the 344 is effective immediately and may have shaved off over ₹1,500 crore from the India's ₹1.18 lakh crore pharmaceutical industries. Brands going off pharmacy shields include Saridon, Texam, is it according to the market research from A IOCD hours formatted. So I'm ending this slide for now. Let's move forward to health part 3. So thank you. Have a nice day.